Let me show you an example of CSS position and Z index in the wild. Google Maps. Probably most of you have used Google Maps or some sort of online mapping service before to help you find what you're looking for. And these things are just really cool. We can browse around and we can zoom in and we can zoom out and we can look for things. So since I'm in Barcelona right now, I'll look for Sagrada Familia, which is this beautiful church. This is actually HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. But let me show you all the Z index that's going on here. So all the different elements that we see, these have all been positioned using CSS to be on top of each other. And they're using Z index in a very particular way to make sure that the order is exactly correct. So let me just use my Chrome console to show you a few things. This mini map here in the corner has position absolute, bottom 0, left 0, and a z-index of 1. So that should put it above something with a z-index of 0. This hover card that shows up and has all these options here, it has position fixed and then a z-index of 10. So it shows up on top of a lot of things. The zoom button has a z-index of 2. So that should mean that it ends up underneath the hover card. Let's just move this over here and see what happens. See, the hover card that shows up above that zoom because it has a z-index of 4 and the zoom has a z-index of 2. As you can see, Google Maps uses a lot of CSS position and z-index in order to lay out all the map and controls on top of it. It does use a lot of other CSS and JavaScript as well, but it's pretty neat that now you can start to understand how other websites are built that look nothing like the ones that we've been showing so far. That's the power of CSS.